Shares versus property. Which should you invest in? Hey guys, today we're going to know which you should invest in between shares or properties. Let's get right into it. Properties or shares? Both can be money makers or money pits if you don't do your own research and seek professional advice before investing your hard-earned money. Even professional financial advisors do not have a crystal ball to predict which type of investment strategy will best grow wealth, so it is prudent to examine the hard facts. Doing your homework and seeking professional advice can all help you find a strategy that works for you and your financial objectives. So, what is the wiser investment? Many investors have traditionally turned to the stock market as a place to invest their money. While stocks are a well-known investment option, many people are unaware that purchasing real estate can also be considered an investment. Under the right conditions, real estate can be a better investment than stocks, with lower risk, higher returns, and greater diversification. Individuals require an investment strategy that fits their budget and needs, whether they are planning for retirement, saving for a college fund, or earning residual income. A good place to start is to compare buying real estate to buying stocks. Whether to invest in real estate or stocks is a personal decision that is influenced by your financial situation, risk tolerance, goals, and investment style. It's safe to assume that more people are investing in the stock market, possibly because it takes less time and money to buy stocks. If you want to buy real estate, you'll need to save and put down a substantial amount of money. When you buy stocks, you are purchasing a small portion of the company. In general, there are two ways to profit from stocks: value appreciation as the company's stock rises, and dividends. When you purchase real estate, you are purchasing physical land or property. Most real estate investors profit from collecting rents, which can provide a consistent income stream, as well from appreciation as the property's value rises. Furthermore, because real estate can be leveraged, you can increase your holdings even if you can't afford to pay cash up front. Real estate is appealing to many prospective investors because it is a tangible asset that can be controlled, with the added benefit of diversification. Real estate investors who purchase property have a tangible asset for which they can be held accountable. Real estate investment trusts, or REITs, are a type of real estate investment that can be bought and sold like stocks. When deciding whether to invest in stocks or buy real estate, investors must consider a number of factors. Investing in stocks makes the most sense when combined with benefits that increase your returns, such as company matching in a 401k. However, these benefits are not always available, and the amount you can benefit from them is limited. Investing in the stock market on your own can be risky, and the return on investment is frequently lower than expected. Comparing real estate and stock market returns is an apples-to-oranges comparison between the factors that influence prices, values, and returns are very different. However, by comparing the total returns of the SPDR S&P 500 ETF and the Vanguard Real Estate ETF total return over the last 17 years, we can get a general idea. As observed, both real estate and stocks can take a big hit during economic recessions. Note that big dips occurred during the 2008 Great Recession and the 2020 COVID-19 crisis. How about the risks? The most important risk that people overlook when it comes to real estate is that it necessitates extensive research. It is not something you can enter lightly and expect immediate results and returns. Real estate is not an asset that can be easily liquidated or cashed in quickly. This means that you can't cash it in if you're in a pinch. There are risks associated with handling repairs or managing rentals for home flippers or those who own rental properties. Some of the most significant issues you'll face are the costs, not to mention the time and hassle of dealing with tenants, and you might not be able to postpone them if there is an emergency. As an investor, you may want and need to consider hiring a contractor to handle your flip's repairs and renovations, or a property manager to oversee the upkeep of your rental. This may reduce the bottom line, but it does reduce the amount of time you spend overseeing your investment. On the other hand, the stock market is vulnerable to several types of risk, including market, economic, and inflationary risks. First, stock values can be extremely volatile, with prices subject to market fluctuations. Geopolitical and company-specific events can both cause volatility. Assume a company has operations in another country. This foreign division is subject to the laws and regulations of that country. However, if that country's economy suffers, or if political problems arise, the stock of that company may suffer. Stocks are also affected by the economic cycle, monetary policy, regulations, tax revisions, and even changes in interest rates set by a country's central bank. Other risks may be posed by the investor. Investors who do not diversify their holdings expose themselves to greater risk. Consider this. Dividend-paying stocks can provide consistent income, but it would take a significant investment in a high-yielding dividend stock to generate enough income to last a lifetime without selling additional securities. Investors who rely solely on high-yield dividends may miss out on opportunities for higher growth investments. Keep in mind that many investors put money into both the stock market and real estate. And if you like the idea of investing in real estate, but don't want to own and manage properties, an REIT might be worth a second look. That's all for today, and we'll be sure to catch you all in the next one.